Hello all, this is Dr. Alsup, and in this learning objective video, we will be discussing the joints of the hand. So all of those long named joints that we introduced in the first MSK session, we will spend a bit of time discussing what types of actions can occur at these joints, and again, just really trying to identify them. We will start with the most proximal of the joints of the hand, and these are the carpometacarpal joints, often abbreviated so we don't have to say carpometacarpal so many times, to CMC. These CMC joints are formed by the articulation between a carpal bone in the distal row and a metacarpal, so they are going to be located in this general region. And there will be 5 CMC joints in all, 1 associated with each digit. Most of the carpometacarpal joints are plane joints. So 2 through 5 will be plane joints. So there will only be gliding movements allowed at the CMC joints. The one exception is the thumb, the first digit or the thumb, where this particular CMC joint is a saddle joint and capable of considerably more types of movements with a greater range of motion. And you can kind of just do this on your own. Try to move your CMC joints of 2 through 5. Not so easy, but try to move your first CMC joint and you have quite a bit more going on there. So the carpometacarpal joint of the first digit is capable of flexion and extension, which uniquely in the thumb is going to occur in the coronal plane. So flexion can be moving in the coronal plane towards the palm, as you can see here, and extension is going to be away from the palm, such as like jutting the thumb out laterally, like in what is sometimes called a hitchhiker's thumb. Now, most abduction and adduction is going to occur in the coronal plane, but in the thumb, it's going to occur in the sagittal plane. And I often describe abduction of the thumb as, say, you're looking straight at the palm of your hand, and then you try to touch your nose with your thumb. That's going to be abduction. It's also what you do when you are using a sock puppet. Adduction would be moving it back towards the palm. Anytime you can flex, abduct, extend, or adduct, you can also circumduct, and that would be making a circular motion with the thumb. Some of these movements that we've described here are vital in the complex movement of opposition that can occur at the thumb. And by complex, I mean it involves different kinds of actions for more than one joint, but the actions of the carpometacarpal joint of the first digit are very important in terms of us being able to have opposable thumbs. Okay, let's move distally to the metacarpophalangeal joints, another name that has mercifully been abbreviated, but there is not as much standardization here. Sometimes you see the MP joints, sometimes you see MCP joints. This is going to be the articulation between the metacarpals, so these are your metacarpals here in orange, and the proximal phalanges. So I'm drawing a line through the MP joints. And if you're looking at your own hand, the MP joints are what we commonly call your knuckles. Metacarpophalangeal joints are condyloid joints, which means they are capable of flexion, extension, and also abduction and adduction. And then, of course, as you know, if you can do these actions here, you can also circumduct. Abduction and adduction in the hand is not the typical definition of moving towards or away from the body. Instead, abduction in the hand is going to be moving away from the third digit, whereas adduction is moving towards the third digit. So we have a different plane through which we're moving. It's all focused on this third digit. The first digit MP joint is typically described as a condyloid joint, like all the rest, but it's mainly just capable of flexion and extension. Now, on to the many, many interphalangeal joints. The good thing is that these are all hinge joints, so there's no differences here. So that's easier to remember. So they do what any typical hinge joint does, which is flex and extend. There are two main types of interphalangeal joints. There are the proximal interphalangeal, or PIP, joints. You can see where those are located here. And there are the distal interphalangeal joints, or the DIP joints, which are between the intermediate or middle phalanx and the distal phalanx. By the way, I love saying PIP or DIP. Recall that there is no intermediate phalange in the thumb, so there is just the one interphalangeal or IP joint, which you can see right here. Okay. Excellent. We have reached the summary slide, which is your one-stop shop for the foundations of the joints of the hand. Please review and reach out if you have any questions. Have a great rest of your day.